Vortex Race Lever 2.0 install. This is a 2022 Kawasaki Ninja ZX6R. I'll be honest, the setup of these levers looks a little bit different than what I'm used to. It's kind of weird. This is my first time doing it, but we're gonna install them. Should be cut and dry. We're gonna find out. Looks a little odd on the clutch side. We'll do that side first. On the inside. Now we are going to assemble it together just like this. There's a special groove down in here that you can see. The spring fits in there just like that. And there is a special groove here for the spring to connect. So what we're going to do is install this gold piece exactly where it looks like it should go. Just like there. You can grease it up if you want to. Not necessary, but you can. It's going to go just like that. Whoa, and then what we're gonna do is we're gonna hold that gold piece in place and we are going to align that groove with the spring and then we're going to push it into place and get that bolt to go through. Just kind of have to finagle it around, get it to fit, and boom. Okay, so that is the assembly. So let's get this bad boy on here like this. What we're gonna do, we're going to tighten this on here. I like to hold that in place, just like that. Nothing crazy. And tighten just like this. Comes with this little black piece, believe it or not, to put down in there to tighten. See how it spins? So it'll just catch just like that. You do not need to over-tighten. I cannot stress that enough. You do not need to over-tighten. So again, it's going to fit right on. Let's see. That's as far as out as it can go. This is going to be the feel on these ones. Again, this is the clutch lever assembly. I'm going to install the brake lever here in just a minute. But that is how you install. You take two pieces to put them together, and now you can install CRG, Puig, all these other brands probably come in one piece. I know they do because I have ordered them. Vortex comes in two. That's how you assemble it. Let's do the brake. Here's the spring. I was gonna say, I don't remember taking it off. All right. So again, deassemble. Same concept. What I do is I move that out of the way so I can actually work. There's a little gold piece. Again, assembly is going to be very similar. The little tab goes down. We're going to assemble just like this. Exact opposite of the other side. So again, get that spring into place. Then we are going to install the gold piece to fit in just like that. Get the spring to fit. I hold the gold piece in place. I get the spring going first, typically. It makes it easier. Get that spring in there. Yeah, there we go. Again, gotta kind of finesse it in there, wiggle it around, get it to fit. On this one, you kind of have to press forward a bit, apparently. Come on. That's where we need to be. There we go. See, you can see how it's perfect. And now it's actually gonna go in. Allegedly. I am clearly a virgin. I cannot get it in. It's my first time. Or rather, this is a virgin. Nice and tight. Here we go. Flip it over, spin it on. Yeah, you don't even have to touch it. Nice and tight. You'll feel it stop. It just won't want to go any further. And now, it is ready for assembly. There's the clutch lever, or sorry, the brake lever, and the clutch lever is behind me. So that is the installation of the brake lever and the clutch lever for the Race Lever 2.0s from Vortex. Let's install them. So you can see this is what's odd. This little hex right here is kind of clipped in. It's atypical. Now, it has the very stereotypical bolt on the bottom. There's just a little hex bolt on the bottom. It seems like that is going to come off. This looks like it's almost like painted on, like the paint of the black on here. I don't know if you guys can see it. It's just a little odd. I'm going to get that bolt off and then we're going to see if this will just come right out. All right, so what I did was I moved the handlebars forward. So I'm doing the clutch side and I turned my handlebars to the right just to clear a little bit of space for me. It's looking like that's going to be an 8 or a 10 millimeter. I'm going to grab both just to be sure. Let's see. I would assume that it's a 10. It's usually a 10. I think it's going to be an 8. No, it's a 10. But man, they are not making it easy on you. You can't actually even fit this 10 up in there. All right, y'all can see that this is going to be the angle. I brightened it up for you. We're going to zoom in. Let's see here. That is the bolt that we are going to be working on. Cool. All right, I'll show you. So you can't really, that's what we're working on. They really don't want you to change the levers, but that's the bolt that we're working on. You can't really fit, can't fit anything in there. All right, this is pissing me off. All right, so the easiest way to get to that bolt is going to be just to loosen these and then just flip it up. Oh my goodness. OEM. All right, so check it out. So I'm just gonna flip this up here like this so I can actually get access to that bolt. Either way, this is not gonna be fun. All right, so believe it or not, what we're gonna do is we are going to take off this little whole little assembly piece right here. So this is the actual sensor. You can see there's a little clippy thing. So we are going to literally unscrew this and take it off so we can get access to that bolt. They really don't want you taking this lever off, but I'm going to anyway. All right, so flip it up. Two screws, looking like. Very important not to strip these guys. Don't drop these little tiny screws down in your bike, that's for sure. All right, so I got a little container over here, as you can hear. Better. All right, whoa, whoa. Make sure, very important, don't lose that little bolt. I'm gonna grab it, move it over here. Okay, now we have access, haha. Okay, let's take it off. 10 millimeter. Yep, we're going to go lefty-loosey. All right, so remember I told you that paint up top, I'm gonna show you. Again, keep track of your bolts. You have to reuse the OEM bolts. All right, I'm gonna flip the camera around. All right, so again, that atypical hex bolt, here it is. This is a little different than what I'm used to. Here it is, it's a hex. I'm gonna put this up there. And now this is going to slide right out. I'm going to get a different angle so you can actually see the clutch cable coming out. You do have to rearrange a couple things up here. All right, as you can see, you have to align this, right? So there's going to be a groove on both sides. See, it spins two ways. It spins from the actual screw thingy and spins from here. So what you have to do is you have to actually get this to come out. However, we're going to do that. All right, we got to get the whole thing to come out. And then you're going to turn it like this. Again, this stuff has to be aligned, and you see how it's gonna come out, right? So what we do is we see that, that's where it's gonna come. So we're going to, all right, so the actual thing just fell apart because you actually need this, by the way. This is important. This little groove was on top. We're gonna have to reuse this. You have to reinsert this cylinder in your clutch. You have to reinsert it. the old one. But okay, I'm gonna put this in the little bucket. Now, you can see, it comes out just like this, right? So what I do is I give it a little quarter turn so that it doesn't slide back in. All right, now let's assemble the new one. All right, so here is the clutch lever. Now, what we're gonna do is we're going to put that cylinder back in. You can see there's grease all over it. I'm gonna reuse the grease, important. I'm going to turn this upside down, reinstall this special little thingy. This is the clutch cable. See how it's back in there now? And you're going to flip it upside down, and we're going to slide this bad boy into place. Just gotta get it in there, make sure everything's all lined up. There we go. Slide it on in there and get it in place. Then we're going to take those bolts, and again, we're gonna put it back through. Okay, let me go get it. So, here it is. We're gonna slide it on in there. We're going to line it up so it fits well. It's the way that it's supposed to. There we go, see? It's all angled up in there. Let's turn it upside down, and we're going to screw that nut back onto the bolt. Whoa! Let me go get it. Down in there, just like this. Screw it on my hand, and then we're going to reinstall that sensor once I get that all tightened up. All right, so this, because it's in that groove, we don't even need to hold the top. Pretty ingenious, actually, so all we gotta do is put this on and just tighten, and it will do the rest for us. Yep, there we go. All right, now we got to reinstall that sensor. It's going to go in here just like this. I'm going to flip the angle so you can see what we're gonna do here. All right, so this little sensor goes on here, and just like this. And how does it go on? Whoa, whoa, whoa. But anyway, all right, so once we actually hook it on, maybe this way, clips on here, and it sits just like that, right? And it presses, this little penis thingy, it presses. There's a little groove for it to sit into. So you got to get it into place. There's a little hole right here. That's where that little nudge. So you got to get it in place, and you got to put it into the hole. Slot it in, it's gonna fit in just like that. See how it fit right into place? And that, it all has to go together, right? So that's very, very important to note. We're gonna put those screws back in. All right, I got a screw in my mouth, and I got one screw in my hand. I'm gonna flip it up, gotta get this thing in place. I don't know if this is a good angle, I apologize. This isn't easy, because you have to get everything in place. I got two screws in my mouth. Let's finagle it in there. Let's go find out. There's the first screw. There we go. Mm-hmm. There we go. All right, don't over-tighten, because we got to seat this, right? We got to make sure it's actually going in. So let's get this other one lined up, if it wants to. All right, cool, it actually went right in. Now we can tighten them. Again, over-tightening is bad. Do you need the torque specs for this stupid little stuff? No. Do you want to over-tighten it? No. All right. Okay. And okay. So, we're not done yet. There's a few things that we need to note that are very important. All right, we have two more steps. Step number one, we gotta get this lever back to where we want it. If I'm on my bike, I like my clutch right about, because we can move it up and down, remember? So, There's really no wrong way to do it. Some people like them higher, some people like them lower. I like that OEM feel for sure. Yeah, yeah, that's good, perfect. And then you can adjust it any way you want. So I'm gonna have it all the way out right now. Now, well, here's what I'm gonna do. We have one more step. The last step is we have actually changed the friction zone, right? So the wetness of your clutch, when and where it picks up. There are OEM specs to pay attention to. Now, it's 10 millimeters of play before it actually picks up. Now, on this one, it's hard to track. So what we're actually gonna have to do, we're gonna have to tighten it up in here, and we're gonna have to figure out where it's gonna pick up. So we're gonna have to turn our bike on and be in first gear and let on and off the clutch, right? Because you don't want to wear your clutch out. There are factory specs to pay attention to. I'm not gonna pay attention to the factory specs because I know what it should feel like on my bike. So that's what we're gonna do. It shouldn't have changed that much. I'm gonna tighten this a little bit more. And that's probably pretty good. I'll show you guys exactly what it looks like. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we are moving on to the brake side. The brake side is way easier. One bolt, take it out, put it in, screw it in. That's all we're gonna do. I'll be right back. We're gonna use a flathead. Now, the flathead cannot come out until we take the bolt off the bottom. There's a bolt on the bottom, just like the other side. You take that bolt off, then unscrew the flathead, and then it comes right apart. I don't think there's a cylinder in there. There might be a little bearing, even so. Much easier, no adjustments. All right, it's looking like we're actually gonna have room on this one. Come from the backside, that brake line might get in the way. See here. The brake line is gonna get in the way. All right, I'll just use the regular wrench. Won't be that big of a deal. Left? No, that's right. That's right. That's left. Aha. Yeah, something like that. All right, that actually came off pretty easy. Yeah, once you break the torque, you can just use your hand. Do not drop it. Nice and shiny. Put it in here like this and unscrew it. This one's a little tricky to put the lever on. Kind of have to finagle it in there. And also to get this out, and I gotta wiggle it around, all right? There's a cylinder in there. I don't know if it's gonna fall out, but here's what it looks like. Super weird, right? All right, this actually should just come right off. And it did. All right, we're not gonna have to reuse that cylinder. Cool. All right, what we're gonna do is we are going to grease up that bolt and put the new one on. Let's do it. All right, I came in nice and close because I want you guys to see this. Now, this little nodule right here, you can see in there, in the gold. Let's see if it'll focus. You see in there? There's like a little nodule. You can see that there's a groove for it to go into. That's what we're putting it in. It's gonna go in like this. And this right here, this is what hits that little brake light switch, right? That switch that goes click, 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 click when you open and close it. That's where we're going, okay? So, it's gonna fit in here. I'm gonna make sure it all goes in nice and pretty. Again, it's important for it to fit into there. It seems like it is. All right, so what we're gonna do is it's in place. Again, it's important. You gotta make sure that everything is in place. There's still some grease on here, so we're all good. You gotta finagle it in there. You gotta kind of press it and compress it. Again, it's a pump, it's a brake. Finesse it down in there, and it's in. So we're doing the reverse. Now that it's in, we're going to screw this down in there. Now listen, I know I might have made that look really easy. It's not. You gotta finagle it. I've put so many levers on and off bikes. This isn't my first rodeo, all right? So it goes in, comes to a hard stop. Then we're gonna grab that bolt on the bottom. We're gonna screw it on. Again, it's gonna come to a hard stop. If you remember I broke that torque and then it came right off. So we're going to be putting it on. All right, sorry guys, my camera overheated. Whoops, it's Florida. But even so, yeah, that's pretty much it. The levers are on. Very important. Test out your bike in your driveway. Go around the block. Don't be an idiot. Don't put levers on your bike and then go rip around and do wheelies and corner. God forbid if something happened, especially if you've never done it before. I've done it a million times. I know exactly what to do, and I still tested it out. The levers are on. Absolutely love Vortex. Don't be stupid.